Hi students, welcome to my class. I'm your Max ma'am. Hope you all enjoying the holidays. Yes, in little bit just to revise the chapters and related sums. Let's pass on to the class. Now I'm going to explain that exercise 1.3. The first sum they have been given. Find each of the following products. Products means that you need to multiply. Multiply means you need to multiply any number represent positive or negative integers. First sum I have given first positive 3 into negative 1. So the answer exists as plus into minus. It forms minus sign. So 3 into 1, the answer is minus 3. Then B sum, they have been given minus 1 into 225. So answer exists as anything to the number multiplied with 1. The answer exists as the same number. So plus into minus, you get the solution of minus sign. So C sum, I have given negative integer, 2 negative integer multiplied means the answer exists as positive integer. Then multiply the two numbers, you get the answer. Then third sum, H sum represent 3 negative integers. 3 negative integers means 3 odd numbers. 3 is an odd number. So odd integer, negative integer exists means the answer need to exist as a negative integer. Then I sum, 4 numbers they have been given. First 3 number they have been given in a negative integer. So the answer exists as negative. So I have solved this sum. Just go through it and solve the answers. Then second sum, they have given to verify the followings. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. Already I have taught in exercise 1.2. Left hand side is equal to right hand side means it is, the answer is equal. Likewise we have solved, no, that same model. The second sum they have been given. Then third sum, first option they given in an, for an integer, any integer a, what is minus 1 into a represent any integer number equal to. Then second option they have been given, determine the integers whose product with minus 1 is minus 1 to related the answer that you need to multiply. The answer is minus 22, minus 37 and 0. These three numbers represent right hand side answer. So by using this minus 1 you need to solve the answer question, given question. So first sum I have been solved. Minus 1 into a is equal to minus a, where a is an integer. Then a sum, the answer exists as minus 1 into minus 22. The answer exists as plus 22. B sum, minus 1 into 37. Then answer exists as minus 37. Anything to the number multiplied with 0. The answer exists as the 0. Then fourth sum, you need to start from minus 1 into 5 with various products. So showing some patterns to show minus 1 into minus 1, the answer exists as plus 1. By using this minus 1 inverse, additive inverse number, you need to find the patterns of extra 5 numbers that you need to write. Here I have written 3 numbers. By using this you can write any number. Okay students, thus we need to write the conclusion to the given question. Thus we can conclude that this pattern shows the product of one negative integer and one positive integer is negative integer, whereas the product of two negative integer is a positive integer. Then fifth sum, find the product using the suitable products, using the suitable properties. By using this property you need to solve the product. Product represent multiply. So first sum, they given in 4-digit number. So 4-digit number means you know very well that number represent distributive property. Then B sum, they given in 3-digit number. 3-digit number, you know very well 3 numbers exist means that is what? Associative property. Very good. But in this associative property and commutative property, you need to see the number. Okay students, the first sum, 4 numbers they given, so I have substituted the distributive property. Then B sum, 3 numbers they given. 3 numbers we also learned by using this associative property, but I have substituted commutative property. Commutative property, you can multiply simply the given number, you get the solution. That's why I have solved by using this commutative property. Then sixth sum, a certain freezing requires that room temperature lower from 40 degree and rate of 5 degree Celsius everywhere. What will be the room temperature 10 hours after the process begins? So you need to write the given present room temperature, decreasing the temperature. Then you need to multiply the given number. You get the solution. This is the room temperature after 10 hours. The degree must be reduces after the process begins. Then seventh sum, in this class test containing 10 questions, 5 marks are awarded for every correct answer and minus 2 marks are awarded for every incorrect answer and 0 or for questions not attempted. Mohan get 4 correct and 6 incorrect answer. What is his score? Reshma gets 5 correct answer and 5 incorrect answer. What is her score? Hina gets 2 correct and 5 incorrect answer. Out of 7 questions she attempt, what is her score? 3 members score, they asking in this question. So correct answer represent 5 mark, then wrong answer represent minus 2, then didn't attempt any question that represent 0 mark. By using these 3 conditions you need to plot in this 3 question, you get the solution. Okay students, I have written the answer. Mohan's mark by adding 4 correct and 6 incorrect, you get the solution. Then Reshma 5 correct and 5 incorrect, you get the solution of 15 mark. And Hina gets the same 2 incorrect and 5 incorrect, the answer is 0. Then eighth question, a cement company earns a profit of 78 per bags of white cement sold and a loss of 5 per bags. In the question itself, they are given profit and loss. Profit represent gain. Loss represent, we have the loss of pay. Loss of pay means we need to give the money to the company. That is loss. Okay students, so loss of 5 per bags of grey cement sold. The company sells 3000 bags of white cement and 5000 bags of grey cement in a month. What is its profit or loss? B sum represent what is the number of white cement bags it must be sell to have neither profit or nor loss. If the number of grey bags sold is 6400 bags. So first unit, I have written the given profit of 1 bag of white cement and the loss of 1 bag of grey cement, that is 35. Then I have plotted in this the given, I have written in this sum also. Again I have written given profit of 1 bag of white cement and loss of 1 bag of grey cement, and then I have substituted the A subdivision. Profit of 3000 bags means 8. 3 into 8 you get the 24,000. The loss of 5000 bags of grey cement, 5000 into 5 means you get the 25,000. Whether it is, you need to compare the amount, that 24 and 25. 24 represent profit, 25 represent loss. So it is loss. So the profit is less, loss is greater. So thus you need to find the difference between the two values of cement, you get thousands of selling of grey cement bags. Then B sum, the number of bags you need to find according to this question, the loss is equal to gain. So this is neither profit nor loss. This is the content in this question. Then fill in the blanks. I have given four sums. In this four sums, you need to find the left hand side numbers. Minus 3 into dash is equal to 27. That 27 is the answer. For this answer related to this left hand side question, you need to solve it. Just divide. Multiply opposite is divide. So 27 divided by 3 means you get the solution of 9. So 9. But answer given in a positive. So you need to multiply with minus 9. Okay students, then you get the solution. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. Likewise. Then B sum, they are given in right hand side positive negative integer minus 35. The first number they are given in a positive. So what is negative? Minus 7. Why we getting minus 7? We need to divide. 35 divided by 5 represent 7. So in this number you need to compare whether the question given in positive or negative. So the number given in a negative. So we are plotting this negative sign. Then see some. Dash into minus 8 is equal to minus 56. So minus 56 is the answer. Minus 56 is negative integer. So negative integer or negative number they given in left hand side. So positive number need to exist. So the answer you need to divide answer with the given number. 56 divided by 8, the answer exists as 7. So left hand side number is 7. D sum my dash into minus 12 is equal to 135. 135 represent a positive integer. Left hand side already they given in an minus 12. So you need to divide this 132 divided by 12, you get solution of 11. So positive integer or negative integer we need to plot. Just think it out. First number they given in minus means the next number also need to exist as minus sign. Minus into minus plus forms. Okay students, you can understand, no? Okay students, now in this exercise 1.3 you have learnt by substituting the properties of addition and also multiplication and also division. So by this properties you can learn more and more by go throughing the exercises and also example sums. Then next, I have given the worksheets two answers. Just to verify that answer, previous video I have given that worksheet, no? Just to verify that and plot the mark and you can correct by yourself. Okay students, then I have given the worksheet 3 also. In this worksheet 3, just go through the answers. You can verify this by getting this. First I have given find the product and the second option fill in the blanks. Okay students, have you learnt thoroughly in this exercise? I hope you all enjoyed this video. I think so. Thank you students.